the council workshop agenda for tonight's meeting. First item on the agenda is the city manager's report on issues raised at prior council meetings.
None at this time.
Next is special event applications.
There are three applications. One is for the special events, I'm sorry, for the St. Patrick's Day parade, which is the same as last year. The date on it is March 12th. The second one is the Valentine's Day party at the seniors, which we coordinate with the West Side Citizens United. And then the third event is the Polar Bear Bike Ride, which happened last Saturday, which I approve and is looking for ratification tonight. That is all.
Okay. Next is items for presentation. This evening it's for Mark Steinberg, which is for 1105 Main Street LLC, the Dollar Tree Store.
And I can start this off. Mayor and Council, on January 23rd, the Planning Board adopted a resolution approving preliminary and final site plan with variances and design waivers for 1101, 1105, and 1183 Main Street. That is located on Main Street between 3rd and 4th Avenues. And part of the Planning Board approval included a condition which reads, this approval is subject to the approval of the Mayor and Council of the City of Asbury Park for any encroachments proposed into any city rights of way by the applicant, in addition to the proposed loss of parking spaces on 4th Avenue and or blocking of the street by any trucks loading or unloading the premises. So with regard to that condition, before you this evening, we have Attorney Mark Steinberg, who is here with Bill Stuckey on behalf of the applicant, to request approval of the Mayor and Council for the encroachments and the other items that are in that paragraph 4 that were in the resolution of approval from the Planning Board. So I'll turn it over to Mr. Steinberg.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen of the Council and Mayor, if Bill, just show us which two sites we're developing, one of which is going to be a Dollar Tree store. Or just show on the one you have there.
Yeah, you want to leave it on the board?
I think everybody can see it from there.
Yeah. Okay.
We're developing.
The addition, we're doing both ends of the block. We call this the Getty site and this the Dollar Tree site. We're adding 5,000 square feet to what was formerly the mattress store. And we have parking.
Okay, so that's going to be the Dollar Tree store.
That's the Dollar
okay.
Tree store.
Well, let's get to the, is there any going to be any loading or unloading on the street?
No.
They've approved a loading and unloading zone
in the
rear?
Yes.
Okay, so there is no loading on the street. I don't know how that got into the resolution or why.
And we should also say, just so the public's aware, that our, I think you've been working with our planner.
Yes.
Our planner
right.
had
yes.
some
And I know
concerns.
You have some questions. There.
Yeah, so, you know, we had hoped she would be here. Those of you that don't know, she had a personal emergency. She couldn't be here today. So just so everybody's aware.
Well, and Fred called me and said, do we want to change it? Because I know you have questions of her, but I thought maybe the visuals may limit the questions to her.
I just want to backtrack a little bit. When we, after we submitted the application in July, we met with Michelle a month later and we made changes to the plan, and then we did it again. And this represents the final version of what Michelle told us you all would approve. But obviously, you have to approve it. It's not for her to say.
Well, but the Planning Board has approved it.
Yeah. Well, no. Technically, the Planning Board has not approved it because...
Well, except to this condition.
Yes, because Michelle made changes to the landscaping plan, location of bike racks, and trash receptacles. So we need to talk about that tonight. But this represents the plan that she told me that she would approve and recommend to you, the council.
So we're going to develop the corner of 3rd Avenue and Main Street with the Dollar Tree store.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
The Dollar Tree store and all the loading and unloading is in the rear.
Yes.
There are no new curb cuts.
No.
And so we're not eliminating any parking spaces on that site on the street.
No.
The one in the back, which is the old Getty station, by the way, is going to be retail on the first floor and residential on the second floor, which we approved for, with parking spaces in the rear or side, I guess, off of 4th Avenue, to be used during the day by the retail and the evening by the residences, with some cross easements. Is there any new curb cuts on that one?
Yes, this curb cut is shifted from this portion of the site further west, a along Fourth Avenue.
And you're closing up all the curb cuts on Main Street?
Yes, there are two curb cuts presently on Main Street.
For the old Getty gas station?
Yes.
So basically you have a net increase of on-street parking in that area?
Yes.
So we're not losing any, okay, on either site. All right, so the first thing that we want to talk about, if you bring down the Dollar Tree store, the first thing that we need approval, this comes with an easement from the city, not a license, the other items are licensed. The easement is for the encroachment onto city property of the awnings, I guess.
Yes.
Joe, as well?
Okay, we, as part of the design, we...
By the way, part of that design is Dollar Tree promoted, or from corporate, part of the design.
No, this was our, actually, to step back, Dollar Tree had to specifically approve this unique design for their stores. Because typically they have the arch or the clover leaf with their stores, Dollar Tree in that clover leaf. And when we looked at this, we wanted to do something more unique. And one of the unique aspects of this is this area on Third Ave is going to be a mural, which is, we're going to pay to have painted. It's 65 feet long and approximately 7 feet high. That'll go to the mural committee in town and will be approved by them, and then we will have that done. So Dollar Tree had to go very high up to get this unique store design approved. And they were.
And when you say unique store design, you're saying
unique
not
for
the
Dollar
big
Tree.
Thing. Oh, okay,
yeah,
let's just be clear about
yeah,
it doesn't look that unique, I understand. Unique for Dollar Tree because
okay.
they have certain corporate requirements of angles
yeah.
and arches.
It doesn't look like the ones you see in a strip mall. So what we're, one of the, besides the streetscape improvements I talked about earlier, the street trees, bike racks, and trash receptacles, we have five awnings that we propose for this building. These awnings are made of tubular steel. They are open so that they're not acting as a roof. The rain and snow will come through them. Mm-hmm. And they're just there as an architectural feature. The two awnings on the north side of the building are 10 feet long, and they're 3.5 feet deep. These two are 16 feet long, and the one over the mural is 64 feet long. So
all of which are sort of over the sidewalk, obviously, which is city property, which is the reason we're asking for an easement for that. The some of these requirements were discussed with Michelle, and you can verify later on with her. But we try to meet the Main Street redesign, the redevelopment ordinance, and we had an existing building, and we tried to give it some undulations, some changes, so not just a flat facade. And this is sort of the compromise that came up. With the projections, which the awnings. So that requires your approval and by way of an easement, which starts out with an ordinance.
Correct.
That's the only projection onto city property,
yes.
Other than the streetscape stuff, which we'll go into,
yes.
But that's a license.
Yes.
That's not an easement agreement, and it's not a resolution, I believe.
Well, a license agreement would be approved by the mayor and council by resolution. But it doesn't get recorded like the easement would be recorded like
so,
a deed.
But I believe, and if you can check with Michelle, the only easement that we need would be for the, because this is a permanent structure that the awnings, or whatever they're called,
canopy.
Open, canopies, would be over several feet on over the sidewalk.
3.5 feet.
Over the property owned by the city, because I believe the building comes up to the property line.
Yes.
Most of the building exists now. They've added to it. So we haven't changed the front footprint. Well, show me the part that's added. On that one, right there. I think it's the
yeah. Point. What's added is
back.
From this point,
yeah, back.
Heading north, 47 feet, and it's 100 feet deep.
Right. But the other part of the building is existing.
Yes, from here forward was the mattress store.
So we couldn't move the building back. Any questions on that part? Okay. As part of our approval and part of your ordinance for the Main Street redevelopment, we're also required to do street trees, benches, trash receptacles, and bicycle racks.
Yep.
And
yes.
They're all on the plan?
Yes. I don't know if you got these, but I had printed.
We have smaller copies.
We have small.
We have bigger than you have.
This is connectivity.
Bigger than you have, and
this is the plan that's on the board right now.
We, again, the applicant worked with Michelle on the placement of the trash receptacles, the placement of the benches, and the placement of the bicycle racks, when Michelle files her report or reviews it, this is what she's asked for. And we're going to supply it. And that would require, because it's not a permanent structure, it would require at least a license agreement with the city for the applicant to put those bicycle racks and the benches and the, I don't believe the trees. I don't think the street trees require licensing. I don't know. I don't think so.
I think Michelle included that as part of the overall, but I can.
I would think that once we plant them, they're yours. I'm not sure. But in any event, we do need whatever approvals are required to move forward for the licensing of those items.
What kind of retail are you doing on the other site with the residential?
Right now, we don't have it leased, Amy. It's all 4,800 square feet, and we're designing it so it can be broken into. We get a single tenant rate. If we don't, as you know, it's easier to lease smaller spaces.
And we've gotten approval from the planning board. These are going to be built in two phases. You know, Dollar Tree, we have a contract with them and a lease and a starting date, so that's going to be the primary building. When that's concluded, then we're going to go on to
the Getty site.
The Getty site. Fred indicated that you had some questions of Michelle. I don't know if we can answer any questions or if we give you any other information to assist you, but if you have anything, let us know.
Yeah, after you've looked at that, I'd like to walk you through this on this board. I don't know when you see everything on that 8.5 by 17.
So the parking that's there is there now? Or you're creating that parking?
We're creating this.
You're creating
it. Right where it starts, there's a fence now, and that fence will be taken down, and we're creating the parking here on our lot.
Isn't there a building down there, Interfaith?
I'm sorry?
On 4th Avenue?
Here, by the gate.
Interfaith is on 4th Avenue.
That's Interfaith, I can't see it.
And this, what you proposed here is what the planning board approved?
Yes. Yes. Planning board approved the site plan.
Yes, they approved the
subject
site.
To.
But Michelle
this.
Made changes after
okay.
The planning board approved our site plan. I met with her and changes were made again with respect to the location of the bike racks, the type of bench, the location of the trash receptacles. And she added a couple more street trees, none of which we had a problem with. So, you know, that plan is different. And the plan before you is what Michelle told us we should present to you.
Okay.
Our approval was subject getting her approval of those amenities. So whatever she asked for, we did.
Do you want me to walk you through this? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So we have 8 street trees for Dollar Tree, 4 along Main Street. And Michelle wanted to see, we had had the bike racks, a couple on 3rd Avenue, but she wanted just one there and 2 along Main Street.
Yeah, that doesn't make sense.
And she wanted our trash receptacle close to the front door.
That's not our dumpster. That's
trash receptacle.
Public trash receptacle.
Yeah, public trash receptacle.
Yeah, our dumpster's in the back. We're not talking about ours. We're talking about the one that goes out for the public next to the benches or whatever it's called.
We wanted to create more green space along 3rd Avenue. So we have a 4-foot wide sidewalk there. We didn't see a reason to have 23 feet of concrete. That's it. There are 3 bike racks, a trash receptacle. receptacle and a bench, besides the street trees. And we pretty much have the same thing along Main Street up going towards Fourth Avenue, four street trees, two bike racks, a bench, and two trash receptacles, one in front of each retail store if we break it into two separate tenants. Along Fourth Avenue, we have three street trees and another bike rack and more green space. And, you know, have narrowed the sidewalk. I think it's 4 or 5 feet. It's a minimum of 4, maximum of 5. And we have grass instead of concrete.
And I think the reason that the bike racks are in front on Main Street is because the access to the Dollar Tree is only from the front, not from Third Avenue.
Yeah, and also if they're visible from Main Street, people will use them. They'll say, we see a bike rack there, you know, we can bike there. And, you know, they're much more visible than if they're on Third and Fourth, even though we do have a bike rack for both the Getty site on Fourth Avenue and the Dollar Tree site on Third Avenue.
And the trash receptacles for the retail components, dumpsters or whatever you may be using?
Those are separate, Eileen. The trash for the Dollar Tree is inside the building.
Okay.
And the trash for the Getty site is back behind the building.
Okay.
These trash cans, I took a picture for our engineer, they're the same ones that are at the boardwalk. They have the metal look on the outside, and, you know, that's what we're proposing to put, two of them at the Getty site and one in front of the Dollar Tree.
Are they combination trash and recyclable?
I don't believe so.
Well, that was passed by the planning board, so that has to be.
Well,
they will need.
Yeah, we'll meet whatever requirement is, but I don't think that these are those type. We have all the for all the facilities. We have both.
Yeah,
for the commercial facilities and for the residential facilities.
No, no,
we have
no. The outdoor ones at the planning board. The planning board resolution adopted. Trash / recycling containers.
Okay, so then, okay.
Okay.
So they have two components to it.
Yes.
Yeah, whatever the city, whatever.
So do we have two trash containers side by side, one for recycling and one for regular?
You're fine.
That's fine.
Okay. Whatever. I don't know if you want to cut down the ones. You may not want four. In front of the Getty station. That's up to you. If you want four, we'll give you four. It's two and two. So then we have, it's a lot. when they get, the purpose, I think, one for each possible entrance was the reason. Now you're gonna have, so it was three, now you got six. It's up to you. If she wants six.
It's not up to us, it's what was passed by the planning board. We can't.
No, the planning board was subject to Michelle's determination.
I don't believe so.
Okay.
I mean.
Well, that's why I sort of felt in no man's land here.
Mm-hmm.
I know what was approved by the planning board.
She went ahead and changed it.
And she suggested.
Well, I don't even know if that's right. So that's why we need her here.
I understand. But
I can tell you, I know, because this is what I'm, you know, I know these projects. What was approved by the planning board is not what you have here. There were changes.
I know that.
And so I don't understand, you know, how we actually get something approved here. It was my understanding that we needed to come to you and that Michelle would work with us to revise the plan to present this plan to you. So if we already have approval from the planning board, are we coming here for you to rubber stamp it or to give us input and change it so that you'll approve it?
I think you were just coming here to get an easement of using the public right of way.
That
not to change the planning,
well,
board, not to change the planning
to
board decision.
Encroachments into the right of way.
Right, you're
but
coming.
And you're going to have to speak to Michelle because she took it upon herself to change the approval.
Okay.
Now, if you want to, if it can be done, okay, it can be done both ways to satisfy everybody. I'm sure the planning board would appreciate her input. I don't know why she changed it afterwards. I did not attend the planning board meeting when the original approval was given. I was on vacation. But everything was approved, and we wound up getting the site plan that we had submitted to approve. Subsequently, she said that we should move these things. I don't think the planning board would object, and many times these things are done as a field change. for something as minor as where to put the bike racks and where to put the trash cans. That's what we're talking about here. The balance of the stuff is all on the plans. The,
yes.
The awnings are on the plans.
The awnings were
it's
on
just,
the plans.
Right. It's
so
just
my only point, I think the reason we called you was because we don't have Michelle here, right, to clarify some
that.
Of these issues, and we didn't want to put you out tonight.
I was here working.
Yeah. No, I'm just
yeah,
saying,
here.
Part of the reason we called you was to say that, you know, Michelle's house was broken into.
Yeah, we
so,
heard
that.
We heard
yeah,
that.
So,
no,
okay.
We have no problem. It's just the changes that Michelle made are extremely minor, obviously. Where to put some bike racks and where to put some trash cans. I'm sure if she had told that to the planning board originally, it would have been on the plans.
On our plan.
On our plans, but it wasn't. She wants to change that. I don't think we need to go back to the planning board. I think the planning board could be told about it and accept it as more or less a field change, but that Michelle can work that out. I think that this council and Michelle have to decide how they want to proceed, and then if they want us to go back to the planning board,
we'll have to confirm that, you know, procedurally, whether there's any further planning board review and approval that's necessary.
I would like to. I'm
we got a contract
this done without going back to the planning board somehow. Not that I don't
sure.
like them and have a problem, but we have deadlines and we'd like to continue to move forward with our compliance process.
Okay.
And again, I said these are, you know, where to put the trash cans and where to put the bicycle racks. I don't think the planning board got that detailed into the minutia. Sort of
Oh, yes, we did.
Yeah.
You prefer where it was originally?
No,
yes,
I'm saying that they got into the minutia.
We got into the minutia.
Yeah.
Right.
We got
you
into
would
the
prefer
weeds.
It where it was originally planned for?
I'm only one of nine.
Right.
So,
I mean.
But we did talk about it in detail. And we did, originally, there was a lack of bicycle things, and we increased it, but the numbers. It, on this report still do not match the numbers that was approved by the planning board.
They wanted more than
I don't know what to say.
Six
how
bicycle
many,
racks?
That can hold how many bikes?
Oh, I don't know. How many
we
bikes?
Had, we had, these can hold, their doubles, four bikes. So we have enough bike racks in the Dollar Tree to have 12 bikes. I did not bring the plan that was approved because I thought we were beyond that and we were coming here to talk about and approve the changes that Michelle had suggested. So I'm at a loss. I don't know what
I think we're both in the same boat.
I wasn't there at the meeting and I don't know.
But it's what's on the plan. Like I remember the old plan. We had a big bike rack here at the corner of 3rd and 4th.
Now you had a small one, the planning board said put a big one.
Yeah, and we
correct.
Did that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think we added a street tree. We had proposed that you would agree to have the bench over on 3rd. I didn't think this, you know, whatever Michelle wanted was fine with us, but this kind of looks like a bus stop location, you know, a bench right on Main Street. So we were going to have the bike rack over here on 3rd. But I don't know what to do at this point. You know, Michelle suggested these changes and they were done. And I mean, they're not done, but they're on this plan.
Right.
So if you, the council, want to do something, do you have
jurisdiction?
Well,
you're here before us on the air rights
On the encroachments into the city right of way.
Yes.
The council doesn't have any jurisdiction to modify a site plan. That's all planning board.
Okay.
My understanding of the reason for the appearance tonight before council was simply to ask for the encroachments into the city right of way. The license agreement for them were minor issues, and the easement agreement for the permanent encroachment regarding the canopy.
Okay.
So as obviously,
we
need
Michelle.
To clarify some things with the planner.
I wasn't about. I don't know how she changes something if you're.
Yeah, and I can also speak to the planning board attorney, but.
This council doesn't have people
right.
to modify
right.
your
then,
planning.
Okay. Then,
you know.
Then I would appreciate it if someone from the council would talk to Michelle that she...
Michael will,
yeah.
City manager.
Yeah, whether or not you want to go with the original plan, we'll just put them back where it was, or if it's minor enough that the it can be presented to the planning board and indicate if they're satisfied, it could be considered almost a field change because it's the same... concept.
Okay.
But in a different location. that, you know, we'll do whatever you want, but we're pushed between whatever we need. Definitely need the air rights for the canopies, and of course the licensing for the other items. And I don't think you need licensing for the trees, I just
think
it will become city property.
And I just wanted to show you, probably haven't seen this, this is the building at the Getty site.
Wow.
There's, the retail stores are obviously on the bottom, and we have four apartments above, two bedroom apartments, with, that will have balconies overlooking Main Street, and the parking's in behind, and, you know, worked hard on it, and I think it's a unique looking building, it's not cookie cutter, and,
And when are you looking to start that project?
We'll probably, I've talked to Pat about it, we'd like to, get our foundation in the summer, early fall, and get it under roof, by the time the snow flies.
So 2017 summer?
Yeah, we're gonna try and get the foundation, and we've got a couple other projects in town that we're working on, so.
We're gonna come in with Dollar Tree first, though, right?
Yes, yeah, oh, yeah, we're working on that, we tore down the Tex-Mex bakery and have demoed the inside of the mattress store, so that's, we're doing as much as we can, as soon as we get through compliance, we'll apply for our building.
And this is obviously one of the items, resolution compliance before we get our building permits, so if you guys could talk to Michelle and find out which way we're going, and how minor or major it is to go back to the planning board.
Oh, okay, thanks for your time, sorry I misunderstood the process.
Well, I know, it's a different process.
No, and sorry that we don't have Michelle here, normally we have notes from Michelle, a conversation with Michelle, and then she would be here, so.
Well, we can, of course, yeah, we understand that.
So we apologize for that.
And if I need to come back, I will.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Pete.
All right, we'll move on to review of this evening's regular meeting agenda.
On the consent agenda, the first resolution is a special events application. The second resolution, which is 2017-65, is ratifying the appointment of a new member of the department committee. Resolution 2017-66 is a standard resolution releasing the performance bond of 527 Lake Avenue. 2017-67 is our application for DOT for Heck Street Improvement Project. This is the DOT funded grant in which we're proposing repaving a portion of Heck Street and redoing these sewers underneath it. Resolution 2017-60.
Hold on.
You're on 68?
I'm on 68 right now.
All right, go ahead.
It's a reimbursable grant of $5,500 for, the police department for, overtime for safety of U-Drive, U-Text, U-Pay. This is a standard grant that we receive normally,
Question, so it's only for the period from April 1st to April 21st?
Yeah. Resolution 2017-69 is the city making application for the local finance board. This is for our capital improvement program. We have to do this as a qualified bond act.
Thank you.
The local finance board hearing is March 8th. The next council meeting after that, we can approve the second reading of the capital. Resolution 2017-70 is approving the disposition of surplus property. This is property that the fire department no longer needs. Resolution under individual resolution 2017-71 is amending the temporary budget appropriation for 2017. These two vendors want payment, one the county, one the JIF. So we're proposing amending the budget to put more money into these accounts to pay our insurance and pay the county.
So our liability insurance didn't go up?
It went up approximately, I think it was 2% or 3% from the previous year. Resolution 2017-72 is the bills. Resolution 2017-73 is the 2017 beach season. There's one change from last year. It was more open-ended. I believe the date is around the end of October for people to remove stuff from their lockers. This year, we are requesting that everyone remove items from the lockers by September 30th. We had some issues looking at this last year with possible storms in October, and we wanted to get, make sure everyone had their items out of the lockers. Resolution 2017-74 is an MOU with the IPS group for a free parking meter trial. This is at the request of the transportation planner and myself. The city attorney has reviewed the MOU. We are getting a free meter for a 6-month trial period to see how their meter works. It's going to go on Madison Avenue. We might move it around. There'll be another one as we're going to bring in another company's meter also.
So can I just say one thing with that? You got to put it in the waterfront, because the salt water destroyed, part of the reason we lost a ton of money in our previous meters, which was a disaster, is because the salt water destroys these meters. So any meters you get, they'll make it on Madison. That isn't an area of the city that's going to be a problem. You have to put them in the waterfront.
The plan is, since it's starting in March or April, is the first month or two, if we want to see how they hold up with their solar battery packs.
And Madison's a dark area.
It's a dark street.
Towards the ocean.
My only point is that you absolutely have to move them to the waterfront.
We know that we want to try to get them in different spots in the city for different conditions.
So can we get more than one?
Well, no.
We asked for two. Two from each, and we're waiting for a response.
This one said one.
Right.
We're waiting for the other one. So you should have that sometime in the next meeting or the meeting after that. But we are going to move them around. We know they have to go various places. One of the discussions, as you saw, the JCP&L rep was here. Myself and the transportation planner, we need to find a way to hardwire these things, because the solar batteries, they don't last as long, and that's one of the big things with testing it. The current meters have issues with the salt water because they're not fully enclosed. So that's one of the things that these meters, that the newer meters, even from the current one we currently have, are fully enclosed.
Are both sides of Madison dark?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there'll be a note on it asking for your response. Was this a friendly meter? Was this, well,
oh, good.
To get feedback from the public.
Yeah, we have a couple places where DPW has already poured the concrete slab so we can move them around. We have to follow the city's ordinance of where they can go, obviously, but we're going to be testing out a bunch of them to move forward. Resolution 2017-75 corrects an administrative error that happened 10, 15 years ago, where that portion of the Westside Community Center had a tax lien. They paid it. We're giving the property back to them after finding out that this has been an error. And the final resolution is 2017-76, urging the state legislature to override Governor Christie's conditional veto of equal pay. For second reading ordinances, I might go through those. Ordinance 2017-3 is mandatory direct deposit. 2017-4 is personnel, which is changing the quote-unquote law personnel in the city code to comply with state and federal regulations on appointments. 2017-5 is departments and divisions of the police department. This is going to create a table of organization that complies with existing law. And ordinance 2017-6 is fees code of the city of Asbury Park. This amends the fee ordinance in various places. One thing to remember for ordinance 2017-5, that the numbers you see are up to as many people. That does not mean you hire or we hire or is authorized to hire, but it allows for some flexibility as we receive the COPS grant for the patrol officers. That's all.
All right, we'll move on to matters by city council.
I have nothing at this time.
Nothing, thank you.
I have nothing at this time, also.
I was just going to say Danny McGee did a great job at the pancake breakfast for the Little League. I think all of us got there, and it was a really lovely event.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay. I'm glad you're sitting down. A couple months ago, we went out RFPs for the City Hall lot, and I know we're still in the reviewing them. What I strongly think we should do is reject them all.
We are. We didn't get it on the agenda time.
Okay, and go back out to RFP with a longer timeframe where we'll get more proposals.
Yes.
You agree?
Yeah, we just, I just didn't write the resolution in time for this meeting. The rejection will be to substantially change, because you have to reject for a reason under the law.
Okay.
And we found inconsistencies in the proposals for the community gardens. The community gardens is currently on the Rossi. And so some people built on the Rossi, which we want to make sure that if you're going to build on the Rossi, you meet the requirements of 2-for-1 space. So I just didn't have time to write the resolution of, we're going to recommend rejection at the next meeting and then go back out, substantially changing the requirements to include that.
Okay, good. I just don't want you, Michelle, and the rest of the staff going through a bunch of ones you have in your office when we're going to reject them and go out for more, because the timeframe was too short the first time around.
We had 5 or 6 respondents, one pulled out. The estimated cost ranged from anywhere from $50 to $75 million. I think that the Rossi issue will raise it a couple million dollars. One of the other issues that we found was people were vague on financing, which we would expect, but we also want to hammer that in a little bit tighter, saying,
please,
how do you think you could pay for this in your time frame?
Right.
Because we know that it is such a big $50 to $75 million, people are going to be looking for financing. But everything also included additional parking for this facility.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you. That's all I have.
There is one thing. The master plan meeting for tomorrow night has been canceled. We don't have a new date yet, but, and the one for February 21st is still on, and that will be at the senior center at 6 o'clock.
And there's no recycling tomorrow. So if you're hearing that out in TV land, it's 2 weeks too late. That's it.
All right. Matters by the city manager?
None.
Matters by the city attorney?
I have no matters at this time.
All right. At this time, we'll break until the regular council meeting at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
Tonight, the regular meeting. Roll call. Councilmember Chapman?
Here.
Councilmember Clayton?
Here.
Councilmember Kendall?
Here.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Here.
Mayor Moore?
Here.
Please rise for a silent prayer or a moment of reflection, please. Flag salute, pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. As to comply with the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975, adequate notice of this meeting has been provided in the following manner. The annual notice was forwarded to the Asbury Park Press, the Coast, and the Star Ledger on January 3rd, 2017, and posted on a bulletin board the same date. All notices are on file with the city clerk. Our first is recognizing the organizers of the Asbury Park Women's March.
Sure. All right.
Yay. Recognized
and intersect with issues concerning every group. Whereas these four women organized the 2017 Women's March in Asbury Park in a show of solidarity to women worldwide, with a diverse group of speakers spreading a message of love, activism, and awareness of issues affecting all women. And whereas the Asbury Park Mayor and Council are thankful for the time, energy, and hard work to these extraordinary women in coordinating an incredibly successful 2017 Women's March Asbury Park. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Mayor and Asbury Park City Council proclaim that today, February 8, 2017, be declared Women's Day in the City of Asbury Park, mm-hmm. to honor Danielle, Amanda, Dallas, and Jennifer for all their work in raising our voices along with those around the world in the 2017 Women's March in Asbury Park.
Wasn't it?
It was confirmed.
Confirmed.
Yeah.
It was larger. 7:30, there's no public session.
See, it's lopsided with that down here.
All right, we'll move on. We're back to matters. We had matters in workshop, but if there's any further matters from the city council?
I have nothing at this time. Matters? Matters? You guys have matters?
Yes.
Okay. Now we move on to matters by the city manager. We have scheduled this evening the State of the City address.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. This will be posted on the website the next day or two also. 2016 was yet another year of growth and change for Asbury Park. We are pleased to report that the majority of our goals laid out last year were either accomplished altogether or have at least made significant progress. It's been a year of breaking grounds with building projects, additions to City Hall personnel and policies, and updating the technology and services provided in Asbury Park. As we look forward to what is planned for 2017, we take a moment now to look back on all that was accomplished in 2016. We continue to work with our partners in 2016, bringing exciting new events and developments to the city. These included continued cooperation with the Asbury Park Board of Education and the Asbury Park School District, the Asbury Park Housing Authority on the Boston Way and Choice Neighborhoods grant process, Interfaith Neighbors on development of the Turf Club, sorry about that, and the Asbury Park Music Foundation on the Levitt AMP Springwood Summer Concert Series. With the help of other local organizations, we also brought Wi-Fi to the beach, assisted in the creation of the Salt School at the Asbury Hotel, built the playground at Our Lady of Mount Carmel School, rebuilt Atlantic Park, planted the Pulse Orlando Memorial Grove, and dredged Deal Lake. Beyond Asbury Park, we worked with New Jersey Transit to maintain our level of train service and passed a resolution asking for more trains later in the day directly from New York to Asbury Park and increased our shared services in agreements with Monmouth County, Neptune, and Lock Harbor. Asbury's changing fortunes have drawn attention from all over the state, country, and the world. As exciting as this period heralded as a renaissance can be, we will not leap into action without a framework and vision for the future of the city. The Mayor and City Council are committed to guiding the development and growth of Asbury Park by holding to our plans and agreements across the city and amending and revising these plans to fit Asbury Park's changing nature. The Central Business District Plan was amended in 2016, incorporating changes such as noise mitigation measures and expanding the types of businesses permitted along Cookman Avenue. Amendments to the Waterfront Redevelopment Plan are underway and will continue into 2017. We began reevaluating the master plan in 2016, and we anticipate implementing the new plan by late summer or early fall of this year. The Springwood Park was completed in 2016, officially opening the first city-built public park west of Main Street. The park hosted a hugely successful 11 and 3 summer concert series led by the Asbury Park Music Foundation, drawing diverse crowds of music fans every week. Housing changes are ahead for Asbury Park's Springwood Avenue corridor, with funding for a rebirth of Boston Way and the Michaels Group Renaissance Village, projects which will create over 100 units of affordable housing. The city was awarded a $500,000 HUD Choice Neighborhood grant and opened this up to community input in the planning process with the help of consultants to create an in-depth plan for the future of the West Side. We rated and ranked every road in Asbury Park, launching an annual road paving program, which is the first of its kind in Asbury Park in 6 years. The sewer treatment plant was outfitted with repaired diffusers, a new roof partially paid by FEMA, and a FEMA-funded new emergency generator. The Sunset Lake footbridge is currently being repaired using FEMA funds, and the city has completed paperwork for a $40,000 DEP grant to repair Wesley Lake's outfall. The city received a $400,000 competitive brownfield grant from the EPA to identify and clean up brownfield sites so that they can be redeveloped and turned into income generators and job creators. As we repair the infrastructure and facilities within the city, buildings have begun to rise from abandoned or neglected properties. The Asbury Hotel opened its doors in 2016 and was recently named the best new hotel in the entire country by readers of USA Today. The development of the 1101 Ocean Avenue project was approved and construction has begun. Construction has begun on the Fifth Avenue Pavilion, and we look forward to the opening of the event and restaurant space in the future. Improving the lives of those within the city's borders continues to be the primary goal led by the Quality of Life Committee, our annual spring cleanup was another success, bringing together residents and Asbury Park students. We increased our efforts to promote residential recycling, as well as bringing in new containers for recycling and trash along Springwood Avenue corridor. Addressing unemployment and underemployment in Asbury Park continued to be a top priority in 2016, and one in which the city made good progress. A four-year workforce development plan was awarded, and the planning process will start this month. The city continues to require workforce development elements as part of projects that require council approval. This is an ongoing commitment, and one that's manifested in the successful school program at Asbury Hotel, and will be present in the 1101 Ocean Development ahead. Our efforts are ongoing and expanding existing activities that the city can hire local residents for, including seasonal beach jobs and recreation programming. The police and fire department both grew in 2016. Accreditation of the Asbury Park Police Department is underway, and it is anticipated to be finished by late spring or early summer this year. The police department has also been outfitted and trained in the use of body cameras, promoting transparency and citizen confidence. A closed-circuit camera system was installed to monitor various streets and schools. Our public safety forces have expanded, and Asbury Park was awarded a $269,000 SAFER grant to hire more firefighters and a $470,000 COPS grant for more police officers. Both departments are getting a technology upgrade, allowing them to communicate more easily and securely with each other and across other public safety agencies. We work to increase public services throughout the city this year. Wi-Fi on the beach has been implemented in partnership with Madison Marquette and will see its first summer test in 2017. The sound system in council chambers and on APTV's cable and online coverage was updated with more upgrades planned. The city council passed a sterile syringe ordinance and an agreement to implement the program. Asbury Park rated third in the Human Rights Campaign State Equality Index, measuring municipality services and inclusion of LGBTQ concerns. Asbury Park also received recognition for implementing the Street Smart program, a public awareness campaign for pedestrian safety. The Senior Center continued to increase their daily census, were able to purchase a player piano, and finalize the restoration and mounting of the Turf Club marquee in the center's lobby. Many changes came to City Hall itself this year, as we attempted to make the building and people working in it more accessible and helpful. It's an ongoing commitment rather than a goal with a concrete endpoint, but 2016 saw significant progress on the internal workings of City Hall. The personnel policy was revised for the first time in 25 years. New technology was integrated into City Hall's process, including an OPA program to expedite the process records requests, an agenda program to streamline the City Council's agenda building software, and entering the beta testing phase for web-based public performance measurement software. This year brought improved communication through the city's website, social media, and press outreach. The city was awarded with the best web and social media by the Rutgers School of Government Studies Public Information Contest. The long-awaited business committee was formed in 2016 with representatives from a range of Asbury businesses in order to open up channels between local businesses and City Hall. All boards and committees were open to new members in 2016, bringing in more community members with a passion for improving our great city. In the finance department, Asbury Park hired a full-time CFO. The city reduced insurance costs through our joint insurance fund. All utility funds, sewer, parking, and beach, were self-liquidating, meaning that at a minimum, they all broke even, and this was the first time in 2 or 3 years this occurred. The city continues to sell city-owned properties that are too small to develop to adjacent property owners, putting properties back onto the tax rolls where they belong. The code enforcement department was expanded with new staff, including a part-time weekend code enforcement officer to give Asbury Parks 7 days a week service. The property maintenance code was updated from the 1999 BOCA code to the 2015 International Property Maintenance Code. Code will also benefit with upgrades to new technology in 2017, with software to simplify the inspection process and create accessible histories for each property. This year, the City of Asbury Park plans to continue and grow what's been accomplished in 2016. General objectives include creating a Mayor's Wellness Committee, bringing together high school students for a joint council, completing the Workforce Development Plan, hiring an IT director, increasing the use of Nixle for government message as a government messaging platform, exploring a citywide citizen survey after the Choice Neighborhoods assessment is complete, upgrading Asbury Park's credit rating, adopting ordinances managing short-term and summer rentals, developing gateway sign plan, developing welcome kits for both residents and businesses, exploring partnerships with colleges and universities, and continue to explore shared services in cooperation with county, state, and federal agencies. Planning objectives include completing the master plan reexamination report, beginning an affordable housing review, and drafting a fair share housing plan if appropriate, continue to evaluate the City Hall and Transportation Center properties for better uses, review various zoning districts and redevelopment plans to ensure they meet the city's current needs, developing a bike and pedestrian plan, exploring alternate side of the street parking, conducting a citywide streetlight survey, increasing access to bikes and bike racks throughout the city, and working with New Jersey Transit to update bus needs. Recreation and environmental objectives include expanding the arts and entertainment in the city, reobtaining Sustainable Jersey's certification, creating a restoration plan for Sunset Lake, and adopting a beach management plan. Thank you to all the residents, business owners, visitors, committee and board members, staff, and everyone who has helped to strengthen Asbury Park day by day and year by year. We continue to celebrate Asbury Park's rich and diverse past and look forward to what the future will bring. Thank you.
Great. Matters by the city attorney.
I have no matters at this time.
At this time, can I have a motion to open a meeting to the public?
Move it.
Second. Move to close.
Anybody like to be heard? Now you move to close.
Move to close.
Second.
Okay, we'll move on to minutes. We have three sets of minutes this evening. We have January 25th, 2017 workshop minutes. We have January 25th, 2017 executive session minutes, and January 25th, 2017 regular minutes. Have a motion to approve the minutes, please?
Move it. Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
We'll move on to consent agenda. Resolution 2017-64, resolution approving special event applications. Resolution 2017-65, resolution ratifying appointment to the parking committee, whose name is Jordan Modell.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Resolution 2017-66, resolution of the City of Asbury Park releasing the performance bond for 527 Lake Avenue and accepting the maintenance guarantee. Resolution 2017-67, a resolution authorizing approval to submit a grant application and execute a grant contract with New Jersey Department of Transportation for the year 2017 Peck Street Improvement Project. Resolution 2017-68, authorized submission of a grant application to State of New Jersey Department of Public Safety, Division of Highway and Traffic Safety under the 2017 Distractive Driving Crackdown You Drive, You Text, You Pay Grant. Resolution 2017-69, resolution of the City of Asbury Park making application to New Jersey Local Finance Board pursuant to NJSA 48:3-1 at SEC and previous approvals of said board. And 2017-70, resolution approving disposition of surplus property. Are there any resolutions that the council wishes to remove from the consent agenda?
No.
Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve the consent agenda?
Move it.
Second.
Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
We'll move on to individual resolutions. The first one is Resolution 2017-71, resolution amending temporary budget appropriations for 2017 budget. Have a motion to approve the resolution, please?
Move it.
Second.
Are there any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Resolution 2017-72, resolution approving payment of bills. Councilmember Chapman will be abstaining from purchase order 16-00148. Can I have a motion to approve the bills, please?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Resolution 2017-73, resolution establishing regulations for the 2017 beach season. Have a motion to approve, please?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Resolution 2017-74, resolution approving the City of Asbury Park to enter into a memorandum of agreement with the IPS Group for the free parking meter trial. Have a motion to approve, please?
Move it.
Move it.
Second?
Second.
Comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Resolution 2017-75, authorizing the City of Asbury Park to transfer title of property located at 115 DeWitt Avenue, Block 100, Lot 2, to the West Side Community Center, Inc. Have a motion to approve, please?
Move it.
Second.
Comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
No.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Resolution 2017-76, a resolution urging the New Jersey State Legislature to override Governor Christie's conditional veto. Have a motion to approve the resolution, please?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
We're on to ordinances. First ordinance is introduction 2017-7. This is an ordinance amending and supplementing ordinance 2016-19, establishing a restricted parking space for use by handicapped persons by amending the location from 1215 Springwood Avenue, designated as Block 1103, Lot 48, to 215 DeWitt Avenue, designated as Block 1006, Lot 10, in the City of Asbury Park, and amending and supplementing Section 7-36, entitled Handicap Parking of the Chapter 7, Traffic of the Revised General Ordinance of the City of Asbury Park, New Jersey. Can I have a motion to introduce, please?
Move it.
Second.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Did you check with Joel?
Joel's the one that gave this to me.
Okay, now my question to Michael was, when I read this, if 1215 is the Springwood Avenue building, and this is the only handicapped spot there, why don't we just leave this one? It sounds like somebody moved, so they want one in front of the new address. But if we still need one at the 1215 block, because there are none, why not just leave this one there and add another one?
Well, from my understanding of what the ordinance reads, they have to apply for the handicapped parking space. So even though it's not designated to a person, they recheck every year to make sure that the person who applied for it is still applicable to receive it. If they're not, they would have to remove the handicapped parking space anyway. So unless it's a city designated parking spot.
Well, that's what I'm suggesting. I mean,
but that would have to be done through a separate ordinance, I would think, right? Because it's a separate type of separate section.
Yeah, I read it the same way. That's why we didn't make any changes. We wanted to have a separate handicap spot, separate ordinance.
Only in New Jersey. Okay.
All right, we have a motion and a second. Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
This ordinance is set for public hearing for February 22nd, 2017.
Is there a hurry?
No.
No problem. Go ahead.
If you want to start skipping them, that's fine.
Well, on some that aren't hurries, I do, just because of the price of advertising.
Okay.
Okay.
Next is Ordinance 2017-18, amending and supplementing Chapter 2, Administration, Section 2-45.3, Membership of the Wesley Lake Commission. Can I have a motion to introduce this ordinance?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Public hearing is also scheduled for February 22nd, 2017.
He told me to wait.
Ordinance 2017-9, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 2, Fire Department, Article 9, Fees for Emergency Medical Services of the Code of the City of Asbury Park, New Jersey. Can I have a motion to introduce this ordinance?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments or questions? Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
This ordinance is also scheduled for February 22nd, 2017. We're on to public hearing, second reading. First is ordinance 2017-3, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 26 Personnel Policies, creating 26-5 Mandatory Direct Deposit of the Code of the City of Asbury Park, New Jersey. Can I have a motion to open this ordinance to the public, please?
Move it.
Second.
Anybody like to be heard on this ordinance? Motion to close?
Move it.
Second.
I have a motion to adopt ordinance 2017-3.
Move it.
Second.
Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-4, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 2, Administration, Article 5, Departments and Divisions, Subsection 2-7, Law Personnel, the Revised General Ordinances of the City of Asbury Park, Monmouth County, New Jersey. Have a motion to open to the public, please?
Move it.
Second.
Any public comment? Hearing none, motion to close?
Move it.
Second.
And can I have a motion to adopt ordinance 2017-4?
Move it.
Second. We'll just take care of it down here.
Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-5, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 2, Administration, Article 5, Department and Divisions, Chapter 2-8, Police Department. Can I have a motion to open this ordinance to the public?
Move it.
Second.
Any comments? Can I have a motion to close?
Move it.
Second.
All right. Can I have a motion to adopt ordinance 2017-5?
Move it.
Second.
Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
Yes.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Last one, ordinance 2017-6, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 2, Administration, Article 11, Fees of the Code of the City of Asbury Park, New Jersey. Can I have a motion to open this one to the public?
Move it.
Second.
Can I have a motion to close?
Move it.
Second.
Can I have a motion to adopt ordinance 2017-6?
Move it.
Second.
Councilmember Chapman?
Yes.
Councilmember Clayton?
Yes.
Councilmember Kendall?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Quinn?
No.
Mayor Moore?
Yes.
Motion to adjourn.
Move it.
Second.
Brilliant, John. Brilliant.
You guys need to come back every time.